DaVinci Resolve 16 is officially out in public beta. I've been playing around with it, and all I can say is holy. Hey everybody, Jay Lippman here. Welcome back to yet another video. If you're new to the channel and you're into things like video editing, camera gear, and life as a full-time creator, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell so you can get notified whenever I upload a new video. Today we're talking about DaVinci Resolve 16. That's right, I said it. DaVinci Resolve 16. Earlier this week on Monday at NAB, Blackmagic Design announced the new release of DaVinci Resolve. It's officially in public beta. I got myself a copy. I've been playing around with it all day basically, and I'm in love. I mean, seriously, the new tools that Blackmagic Design have added to their editing software, they're amazing. The best part is most of the features, most of the new things that they got going on in DaVinci Resolve actually come with the free version. If you want to get access to some of the new effects and a couple of the new tools, you have to get the studio version, which is a one-time payment of $300. I will be doing that as soon as humanly possible, because honestly, there's some effects in there that I'm pretty excited about. All right, let's get started. One of the biggest changes to DaVinci Resolve in this version is the addition of a new tab. It's the cut tab. And Blackmagic Design is boasting the cut tab as a faster way to edit videos. And honestly, I can see why. There's a ton of cool stuff on here that really makes the editing process streamlined. For one, you'll get dual timelines. So instead of having to continuously zoom in and out of your timeline in order to find the spot where you need to work, you can take a look at your top timeline, which is an overview of your entire story. You can put your playhead where you need to work, and then boom, right below that is your work area timeline, where you can get a closer view of where you're editing. So no more zooming in and out, scrolling back and forth and all that. That's done with. And guys, trust me, you have no idea how much time that saves. I mean, it's ridiculous. Seriously ridiculous. Trying to find the exact spot where you need to edit and constantly zooming out to see the whole timeline, moving your playhead around, zooming in so you can work better. It's a mess. This dual timeline thing, genius, absolute genius. And no, I'm not getting paid to say any of this. I'm just legitimately excited. The other big change is the source film feature, which is just fantastic. See, back in the day when people were using actual film to create their movies, they didn't have digital clips that they had to scrub through and find in and out points. They literally just took the film and they looked and they found where they needed to cut and boom, cut, and it was streamlined and it was fast. And now we have a digital version of that. You just click a button and you can see your entire timeline as if it was film, and you can see all of your clips as if they were film strips. So it's no more just one single window scrubbing through trying to find the right spot. You can actually scrub through it as if it was a piece of film, find the right spot, cut it, find your out spot, cut it, and you're done. Now, like I said, I'm not gonna go through all of these features. There's a bunch of them. The cut tab is just loaded with stuff to make your editing easier. One thing I will mention is that you can now upload to YouTube or Vimeo directly from DaVinci Resolve, which I know a lot of people have asked me about when I talk about DaVinci. They ask if I can upload directly to YouTube, and the answer is now yes, and you don't have to go to the Deliver tab to do that. You can do it from any tab within DaVinci Resolve. That's pretty cool. Personally, I'm not sure how much I would use that, because I kind of like the workflow of exporting it to my computer and watching the video and making sure it's right before it goes onto the internet. But a lot of you asked me about it, and so I'm happy to say that now, yes, you can upload directly from DaVinci. The last thing that I'll say about the cut tab before we move on to the other new features in DaVinci Resolve 16 is that the cut tab was laid out to be able to work from one monitor, which means if you're like me and you edit on a laptop, this is made for you. This is made for portable editing. It actually says it right on their website. Great for portable editing. So, you know, that's cool. All right, moving on. The edit tab got some new features as well, like subtitles and closed captioning. You can upload SRT files or create your own subtitles. You could do that before, but apparently it's new. It's better now. I haven't played around with that, but you know, it's listed as a new feature, so there you go. There's a stacked timelines feature, so if you continuously copy and paste between timelines, you can do that. There's a button you press and you can stack your timelines so you can easily just cut and paste right there. No, No lagging, no switching between stuff. It's, you can just do that. I've tried it. It's pretty cool. There's on-screen annotations. You can actually draw on top of a video using the annotation tool. There's new 2D and 3D title templates that you can play around with. You can keyframe resolve effects, which is really cool. You can back off of the effect at one point, ramp it up at another point. I'm kind of excited about that. And the optical flow feature, which is the feature that I use for slow motion, is improved. They improved it. So a lot of the features that I listed were in previous versions of DaVinci Resolve, but in 16, they're just better. They work better. And that's because Blackmagic Design really improved on their GPU acceleration and machine learning. That's right, AI powered editing. And where that really, really shines is in sound and color. We'll get to that in just a second. First, let's move on to the Fusion tab. The Fusion tab is actually pretty much the same. There's not really anything different there other than the fact that everything just works better because of GPU acceleration and the machine learning. All right. Let's get into the really good stuff. The color tab has gotten so, so much better. First of all, they've got this new feature called Super Scale, which they're claiming you can create 8K footage out of HD footage and it actually looks good. I'm not sure how well that works. I will be testing. Expect a full report on that. Maybe. Probably. The LUT browser is improved. Also, multiple playheads, which means there's no more split screen stuff when you're trying to compare clips. You can actually set playheads in multiple locations on your timeline in order to compare shots when you're color balancing, color correcting, and all that stuff. Scopes and curves also got an upgrade. You can now view your waveform while you're working with curves, and you can see how it changes with each edit, which is super, super cool. With the scopes, you can switch between your shadows, your midtones, and your highlights when you're within the vector scope. You can do a high pass filter so you can see a more detailed waveform in the parade. There's just all sorts of stuff. But the one thing that I'm really, really excited about with the color tab is because of this new machine learning with this new facial recognition with the AI, there's actually improved auto color. So if you're going through and you don't have time to manually color grade everything and the LUTs that you have just aren't working and you just need to get it done and get it out, which happens to me all the time actually, you can just hit Alt A on a clip and it will automatically color it and it actually looks really good. I went through an old vlog of mine, I erased all of the color grading that I had done on it, I went through clip by clip, I did auto color, and when I scrubbed through the footage, everything matched, everything looked good. It does a really good job. Also, stabilizing your footage is so much better. Moving on to Fairlight, the audio editing tab within DaVinci Resolve. There's a ton of new features in the Fairlight tab, including some new plugins for dialogue tracks, which you know I'm a huge fan of. The normalization process has greatly improved. You can actually switch between different forms of normalization, which I'm super, super excited about. For those of you who are in the studio version of DaVinci Resolve, you actually get access to a sound database full of a ton of sound effects that you can customize and use in your footage. It's just all in all a better experience. Now I'll be doing a ton of tutorials on the new features within DaVinci Resolve 16 in the coming weeks. In the meantime, if you wanna see my general DaVinci Resolve workflow, you can go ahead and watch the playlist that's linked in the description of this video. It is my official DaVinci Resolve tutorial series, and it should give you a good head start. All right, guys, like this video if you enjoyed it, share it if you think your friends will enjoy it, and don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell if you haven't done so already. I'll be back on Monday with a brand new video, but until then, thanks for hanging out, and I will talk to you later. See ya.